There are so many videos on how to use Adobe Lightroom, but they all have a bunch of fluff and they don't get to the point. So today I'm going to teach you how to use Adobe Lightroom the quick and easy way. So when you open up Adobe Lightroom, this is what it looks like. And all you have to do is bring your photo in. We're in library. You only have to worry about these two, library and develop. That's pretty much it. So get your picture or your folder, whichever one you want to do, and just drag and drop here. That's all you have to do, and then click import. Don't worry about all this stuff over here. I mean, it's important, but not really. You can get by just doing this. And then go to develop. Now, these are all set up in the order that you should do them. This is very simple. First, you have your white balance. You just move this around on what should be white, but you don't always have to do what should be white. You can just move it around and get some a vague idea of what you want the picture to look like if you look over here, right? So you can get creative with it and get a preview over here. That's the best way I like to do it. And if you do that, you don't have to really use the temperature sliders like this. I think it's very self-explanatory. You move it to the blue side, it gets bluer. You move it to a yellow side, it gets yellower. You move it to the green side, it gets greener. You move it to the purple side, it gets purpler, right? Next is exposure. By the way, I want to point out all these terms that you're going to learn today, they apply to pretty much every single editing software, so they're basically all the same. Exposure. I really suggest you play around with these. That's the best way to learn. You move the slider one way, it gets darker. You move it the other way, it gets brighter. That's all there is to it. I'm pretty sure this is subjective. You like pictures darker, you like them brighter. It's really whatever you want to do. Contrast. You move it one way, you reduce the contrast. You move it the other way, you increase the contrast. Right? Very simple. Now, here it might get slightly complicated, but not that much. Highlights refers to it's the bright parts of your picture, but not the brightest parts. So, if you move it this way, it makes them less brighter. If you make them this way, it makes them more brighter. However, if you want to edit the whitest portions of your photo, then you go to the whites. See? So you make the whitest parts less white, and you make the whitest parts even whiter. Highlights, it's the bright parts, but not the brightest. Whites is the brightest parts of the photo. The same goes to the blacks. Actually, the concept is much more easier to understand with the blacks. You can think of the highlights as the shadows of the whites, all right? So shadows are the shadows. You make them darker, you make them brighter. Blacks are the blacks, Make them darker, make them brighter. You just want to play around with these to make the picture look the way you want to make it look. If the picture is too dark, well, you can increase the exposure, right? But what if you want to make it not the whole picture brighter, just the shadows? So then you make the shadows darker, and so on. Very simple. Texture is exactly what you think. It gives your photo more texture. See? Really, Lightroom is just a lot of playing around until it gets to where you want it to look like. Clarity is kind of like texture. It makes things nice and crisp. I don't really touch these that much, to be honest. The haze is actually a new one. You can't really see it so much in this picture, but if you're doing like a landscape or a picture of a city, in the distance it looks kind of hazy, kind of pollution. If you increase it, it decreases the pollution. And if you decrease it, it makes it kind of foggier. So that's really all there is to it. Vibrance changes certain colors in your picture, like the blues and the oranges. I think it affects the colors that are not the skin tones. If I'm someone can correct me on that. That way, if you're editing a picture of someone's face, or you're editing pictures of somebody that you took, it affects the colors, but it leaves the skin tones more natural. But saturation just makes all the colors more saturated. So that's the difference between these two. Then you have your tone curve. This is exactly the same thing as this, but it gives you a little bit more control because you can make all these dots. And you can think of it this way. These are the whites, right? These are the highlights. These are the midtones. These are the shadows. And these are the blacks. So that's basically it. If you go to the red channel, since these are the shadows, if you want to add red to the shadows, you just make this go up. I mean, red out to the blacks. If you want to make the midtones more red, add a little bit more red. You just have to come here and play, you know. If your picture is, you want it to make it look a little bit green, but you only want it to be green in the black parts, then come here and move the blacks to make them greener. Just like that. So it gives you a lot more control. And same thing with the blues. Let's say I want the whites to be kind of bluish, right? Then I come here, I come to what should be the whites, and I make them more blue or less blue. So you just have to play around with that. These are the color sliders. Basically, these colors can be changed or manipulated. For example, if I click on the red one, anything that's red over here can be changed. You can make it more saturated. You can make it brighter, darker, different hues. If I want to mess around with like the purple colors, I come to purple. I can change the color. I can make it more saturated. It can be brighter or darker. That's it. Very easy, right? You can learn this like in 10 minutes. Split tones. Highlights are the bright parts. If I want the bright parts to be blue, I add a little blue. If I want the bright parts to be red, add a little red. If I want it to be yellow, green, you get the point. It's the same thing as this. A lot of this is redundancy. It just gives you different levels of control. If I want the shadows to be a little bit bluer, or greener, or redder, yeah, you get the idea. That's it. This is detail, exactly what you think it is. It makes pictures more sharper or not. You can mess with it or you don't have to. It's up to you. You want to make it a little bit sharper, you just increase the sharpness and that's it. I never really worry about these. It's not a big deal. Luminance. If your picture is kind of noisy, I don't know if you can see here, it's not very noisy, but if it was, you can increase the luminance and make it less noisy, but the picture loses a little bit of its quality. Actually, this will give you a better idea of noise. Let's see. See these little specks? This is called noise. You increase the luminance, gets rid of the noise, but you lose detail. Usually I increase it by like 20 or something, 20 or 30. These are not that important. I mean, they are, but they aren't. I basically just play with this one. This is exactly what you think it is, lens correction. You click enable profile corrections and you can choose which lens you use and it will try to fix the distortions of your picture. And you can remove chromatic aberration if you want. But I don't really have to worry about that. Transform. It transforms your photo. You click auto. It makes everything nice and straight. But you get these things. So you can constrain to crop. And that's fine. Nice, straight. You can also do it manually with guided. You just draw some lines like this. This should be straight, and this should be straight, right? voila. Not hard, not difficult. And here you can give it a vignette or fix it. And if you're feeling artistic, you can add grain. It's very small to see, but it's there. If you like the film look. So that's it. That's an OBS guide to Lightroom. Oh, and I almost forgot how to export, which is not hard. All you have to do is highlight your photo, click export, choose wherever you want your picture to go to, and yeah, if you want a JPEG, do JPEG. I mean, you can do whatever you want. It's not rocket science. You can change the size. And if you want a watermark, click right there and export. That's all there is to it. So, I hope you enjoyed this no BS guide to Adobe Lightroom. Yeah, go out there and take photos. You can apply this guide to pretty much every editing software. They all do the same thing. And yeah, thank you for watching, and I'll see you around.